When someone mentions installing an app, the first thing that most people probably think of are mobile apps. And when it comes to mobile apps, there are two major ecosystems that people think of. We have iOS from Apple and Android from Google. And these apps are respectively built with the languages Swift and Kotlin. So what are PWAs and what's the buzz all about? As we know, web apps have become quite powerful and have grown quite popular over the last few years. However, what happens when you need a mobile app? Rather than having to rewrite your entire app in a brand new language, what if you could leverage your existing work and allow users to install your web app like a mobile app? Well, I'm excited to tell you that you can. And the technology that's powering this is widely known as progressive web apps, otherwise known as PWAs. So what are the benefits of PWAs? Well, it's based on the idea that web apps should have an app-like experience that users typically encounter on their mobile devices. That said, the primary benefits for PWAs can be found in the following. Number one is the ability to install the app locally. Web apps used to be limited to the user memorizing the URL or having it bookmarked in the browser somewhere. But now, users can actually install the app onto their device as if it were a native app. Web apps also used to be limited by the fact that users had to be connected to the internet, but with PWAs, this is no longer a limitation. Another thing that's great about PWAs is that they're globally accessible. In other words, they're not limited to a certain marketplace or ecosystem like you would have normally when you're creating apps for, say, the iOS ecosystem versus the Android ecosystem. It's the web, so it can be installed anywhere as long as the browser supports it. Other benefits that PWAs are often known for include offline storage and push notifications. Although support for these vary across the ecosystems, and you'll have to check with the browser support when it comes to that. With that, let's take a look at some of the drawbacks of PWAs. And while PWAs are great, it's essential to understand that they are not replacements for native apps, nor do they make them obsolete. Since PWAs are not optimized to run on the hardware of a specific device, this does mean that it has drawbacks when it comes to not having the same functionality that one might typically expect when it comes from mobile apps. Examples include things like Bluetooth, NFC, and high storage capacity when compared to native apps. In addition, while PWAs lag behind native apps in terms of the features that we mentioned earlier, one of the other drawbacks of PWAs is that it's also limited by an issue that we often encounter as web developers, and that is browser compatibility. In other words, features that are supported on platforms such as Android due to using like browsers like Chrome are not supported on iOS just yet, as those are being implemented on Safari and they're on a different timetable. For example, at the time of this recording, push notifications work on Android but does not work on iOS. And while this might sound like a deal breaker, remember that one of the key pieces to mastering technology is understanding the problems you're trying to solve and having acceptable trade-offs in certain situations. And the truth is, for a lot of apps, while these features might be nice, they're not the critical ones that are necessary to providing value upfront to your users. Remember that PWA stands for Progressive Web Apps, and the key word in there is progressive. In other words, while it might not be feature parity with mobile apps, we have taken a big step forward with web apps to allow users to actually install it on their devices, and hence a progressive enhancement on the capabilities that web apps already have. And so, to review, in this lesson, we've talked about what progressive web apps are and where they sit inside the ecosystem, as well as the benefits and drawbacks of the technology. With that said, I hope you'll join me in the rest of this course as we see how we can leverage PWAs with Vue 3. See you in the next lesson.